Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you the most efficient way to create a photo mosaic portrait and how to quickly apply the mosaic onto other subjects. Open a high definition photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one and the other from Shutterstock. Before we begin, if you want to be notified as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, just click that subscribe button and welcome. The first step is to crop our photo to a position we like. Open your crop tool and the crop presets. Click width, height, and resolution and the clear button. To ensure the effect will look similar to mine, I suggest typing in 1800 pixels for the height and 150 pixels per inch for its resolution. Leave the width empty, which will free us to crop it to any shape we want. Drag the crop's bounding box in or out. Once you're happy with the way it's cropped, press Enter or Return twice. To zoom into your photo, press Ctrl or Command and the plus key on your keyboard a few times. Or if you want to fit it onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. To see it at 100%, press Ctrl or Command 1. Place all the photos you want to use for the mosaic into a folder. The number of photos in the folder should be the same for the mosaic's rows and columns. In other words, if we want our mosaic to have 5 photos across, there should also be 5 columns for a total of 25 photos, 5 times 5. If we want our mosaic to have 10 photos across, there should also be 10 columns for a total of 100 photos, 10 times 10, and so on. For my mosaic, I'm using 7 rows and 7 columns for a total of 49 photos, 7 times 7. Go to File, Automate, and Contact Sheet 2. For the source images, use Folder and click Choose. Navigate to the folder. I placed mine on my desktop. Click it and click Select Folder. Under the Document section, the units are pixels. The width is 1800, the height is 1200, and the resolution is 150 pixels per inch. Make sure Flatten All Layers is not checked. By not checking it, it'll allow us to resize each of our photos inside the mosaic. The mode is RGB color and 8 bits per channel. Under the Thumbnail section, we can place them across first or down first. In this example, I have 7 columns and 7 rows, but as we discussed, type in the numbers you have for yours. Check Use Auto Spacing, which will space out each photo in the mosaic equally. Make sure Rotate for Best Fit is not checked. This will keep our photos from rotating. Make sure Use File Name as Caption is not active. This will prevent our photos from including their names below them in the mosaic. Once you click OK, it may take Photoshop a while to process them, depending on the number of photos in the folder. It'll stack them on top of each other in the Layers panel and create layer masks next to them. Before we can adjust each photo's size and position inside its layer mask, we first need to click off the chain links, which will unlink the photos with their respective layer masks. Open your Move tool and tick Auto Select. Now, when we click on any photo in the mosaic, that corresponding photo in the Layers panel becomes active. To resize and position the photo inside its layer mask, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it out or in. To position the photo, place your cursor inside the Transform's bounding box and just drag it. Make sure the photo fills the entire space. Then press Enter or Return. Click on the next photo, which automatically makes it active in the Layers panel, and as before, open the Transform tool to resize and position it. Continue these steps until all the photos fill their respective spaces to your liking. Go to Edit and Define Pattern. Just click OK. Open back your photo and click the Adjustment Layer icon. Click Pattern. Open your pattern preset list and scroll to the bottom. Click Contact Sheet 1. The angle is 0 degrees, and I'll make the scale 30%, but feel free to adjust this if you like. Change the blend mode to multiply and reduce its opacity to 40%. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change the copy's blend mode to overlay. We can bring out more details in the mosaic by adjusting the brightness and contrast of our main photo. First, let's convert the photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, make the photo active and click the icon at the upper right. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. If you don't see the entire window, check Show More Options. It opens with the default amounts. As I mentioned, each photo has its own characteristics of tonality, so feel free to adjust these amounts, especially in the shadows and highlights. For this photo, I'll reduce the shadows amount to 10% and the highlights amount to 10% as well. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.